We'd like to renew our tawheed. We'd like to renew our iman by looking at two important chapters from the Quran. Both of them are known as al-ikhlas, sincerity. The first one, أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم قل يا أيها الكافرون لا أعبد ما تعبدون ولا أنتم عابدون ما أعبد ولا أنا عابد ما عبدتم ولا أنتم عابدون ما أعبد لكم دينكم ولي دين. That is Surah Al-Kafirun. It is a Meccan surah. This surah, Imam Al-Bukhari, he titled it in his Sahih as Qul Ya Ayyuhal Kafirun. It is also known as, like I said, as Surah Al-Ikhlas. It's known as Surah Al-Ibadah. It is known as Surah Al-Din. The topic of this chapter is the chapter of Tawheed, the disassociation from shirk and disbelief. This informs the disbelievers that the Muslims aren't interested in entering their religion as our beliefs are different. This chapter explains the conflict between the Muslims and the believers. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He said, وَلَوْ شَاءَ رَبُّكَ لَجَعْلَ النَّاسَ أُمَّةٌ وَاحِدَةٌ وَلَا يَزَالُونَ مُخْتَلِفِينَ إِلَّا مَنْ رَحِمَ رَبُّكَ وَلِذَلِكَ خَلَقَهُمْ. And if your Lord had so willed, He could surely have made mankind one ummah, one nation, one community, following one religion, meaning the religion of Islam. But they will not cease to disagree, meaning there will always be differing, there will always be confusion, except on him whom Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has shown his mercy. This refers to the followers of the true Islamic monotheism, meaning Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is one alone in his worship. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is one unique in his rububiyyah, in his lordship. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has names and attributes that are unique, that none of the creation or mankind share. The people sometimes are unable to see the truth. No matter how clear the truth is, my brothers and sisters, some people will never be able to see it because the hidayah, the guidance, is ultimately in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's hands. Even though it may be clear, is day. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He said about Ahl al-Kitab, He said, وَلَئِنْ أَتَيْتَ الَّذِينَ أُوتُوا الْكِتَابَ بِكُلُّ آيَةٍ مَا تَبِعُوا قِبْلَتَكَ وَمَا أَنْتَ بِتَابِعٍ قِبْلَتِهِمْ وَمَا بَعْضُهُمْ بِتَابِعٍ قِبْلَةَ بَعْضٍ. And if you were to bring the people of the book, the Jews and the Christians, all of the ayah, all of the proofs, evidences, verses, lessons, signs, revelations, they would not follow your qibla, your prayer direction, nor are you going to follow their qibla. And they will not follow each other's qibla. The non-Muslims, they acknowledge, they recognize that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala exists, except the atheists, those who willingly deny Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's existence out of their arrogance, out of their stubbornness. But the pagans during the time of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, they were all aware and submitted to the fact that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created the sun, He created the moon, and He provides for creations. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He sends down the rain and revives the dead. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He said, وَلَئِنْ سَأَلْتُمْ مَنْ خَلَقَ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ وَسَخَّرَ الشَّمْسَ وَالْقَمَرَ لَيَقُولُنَّ اللَّهُ. If you were to ask them, who created the heavens and the earth and subjected the sun and the moon, they would surely reply, Allah. A person with sound mind and intellect on the fitrah of al-Islam, on the fitrah in that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created him, he recognizes that everything that came into existence is by the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The Muslims, we don't accept the Big Bang theory. We don't accept the theory of evolution. We accept the fact that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He simply said, kun fayakun, say, and it came into existence. The people of shirk, they believe in Allah. However, some people, they place intermediaries between Allah and themselves. Some people call on idols. Some people claim that angels are Allah's daughters. Some people call Jesus the Son of God. Some people go to graves of righteous people and call on them and ask them for help, ask them for favors, ask them for protection. To show the disbelievers that we are different, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He revealed Suratul Kafirun. The kuffar of the Quraysh, they saw the da'wah, the call to Tawheed, the call to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as one. So for that reason, He said, Qul ya ayyuhal kafirun. Say, O Muhammad, to these mushrikun, O al-kafirun, disbelievers in Allah's book, disbelievers in His oneness, disbelievers in His angels, disbelievers in His books, in His messengers, disbelievers in the day of resurrection, and disbelievers in the Qadr. This Qul ya ayyuhal kafirun, it encompasses everyone who disbelieves in the six articles of faith. The six articles of faith from the time of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam up until the last day. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He revealed, La a'budu ma ta'budun. I am not going to worship that which you worship. The Prophet, He informed those polytheists, He informed those mushrikeen that we will worship Allah alone, and we don't worship whatever they worship. Whether it be idols, whether it be stars, whether it be the moon, the sun, or even personalities of individuals or righteous people of the grave. وَلَا أَنْتُمْ عَابِدُونَ مَا أَعْبُدُ. Nor will you worship that which I worship. Even if you worship Allah, sometime or in some areas of worship, we are only going to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone. Even though the polytheists, they worship Allah, but they mix their worship with shirk. They mix their worship with joining partners with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this is what we find today with the people of the book who say that Jesus is the Son of God, or the only way for you to get to heaven, you have to come through Jesus. Now we accept Jesus Christ alayhi salam as a prophet, and as Muslims we believe that He's coming back, and it is from the signs of the hour. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He said, وَلَا أَنَا عَابِدٌ مَا عَبَدْتُمْ. I worship not with that which you worship. وَلَا أَنْتُمْ عَابِدُونَ مَا عَبَدْ. Nor will you worship that which I worship. These two verses are repeated here as an emphasis, as a way of tawqeed, to show them that Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam wasn't going to worship what they wanted him to do. And then at the end of this surah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He said, لَكُمْ دِينُكُمْ وَلِيَ دِينِ. To you be your religion, and to me be my religion. The Islamic religion of Islamic monotheism. This surah is a complete disassociation with the religion of shirk. The Muslim must live by this surah in his life. Anything connected to joining partners with Allah, free yourself from it. And don't misunderstand the last verse, to you be your religion, and to me be my religion, the way that some of the ignorant, misguided people understand it and say, we don't deny their religion. All of these are the religions of Ibrahim. And what's important is that they believe in Allah so that they have their way and I have ours. Some people say it similarly as traveling. The Jews and the Christians and the Muslims are all on the same path. This is incorrect. If that was the case, why did Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala send Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam as the Khatim al-Anbiya with the Khatim al-Mursaleen? If what they're worshiping was correct. Some people, they make an analogy. If we travel to Mecca, you go by car, he goes by plane, and I go by boat, we're all going to the same direction. This is falsehood. The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he refuted that argument when he said, وَالَّذِي نَفْسُ مُحَمَّدٍ بِيَدِهِ لَا يَسْمَعُ بِي أَحَدٌ مِنْ هَذِهِ أُمَّتِي يَهُودِيٌ وَلَا نَصْرَانِيٌ ثُمَّ يَمُوتُ وَلَمْ يُؤْمِنْ بِالَّذِي أُرْسِلْتُ بِهِ إِلَّا كَانَ مِنْ أَصْحَابِ النَّارِ. He said, by him in whose hand is the life of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he amongst the community of the Jews and the Christians who hear about me, but does not affirm his belief in that which I have been sent with, and dies in that state without accepting Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he shall be one of the dwellers of the hellfire. So to you be your religion, and to me be my religion, it doesn't mean that we accept their shirk and their rejection of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The people who worship Allah, pray, fast, perform Hajj and Umrah, and often remember Allah, and make sacrifices for other than Him, this is shirk. The people who seek help from the dead, this is shirk. The people who make oaths and pledges to other than Allah, this is shirk. The people who join partners with Allah is shirk. We can do trade and business with non-Muslims, but Islam is the only path of salvation. Worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone without joining partners with Him is the only way for you and I to be saved in this life and in the next life. Wa qulu qawli hadha astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayk. الحمد لله رب العالمين اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد. The next chapter of Tawheed is بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم كل هو الله واحد الله الصمد لم يلد ولم يولد ولم يكن له كفوا أحد. Say, He is Allah, the One, As-Samad. As-Samad, it means He is self-sufficient. He is the Master who all creations need. He doesn't eat nor drink. And then in the next verse it says, He begets not, nor is He begotten. Meaning He wasn't born, nor does He have children. And there is none co-equal or comparable unto Him. These two chapters, they are closely related. Even in the morning and afternoon adhkar, we recite verses of Tawheed, for example, Ayatul Kursi. But these two surahs, Suratul Kafirun, I said it is known as Suratul Ikhlas, reciting it before you go to bed at night, and if you die, then you are free from hypocrisy. You are free from shirk. This surah, Suratul Ikhlas, whoever reads it three times, as the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, then it is equal to reciting the entire Quran. Whoever reads Suratul Qul Huwallahu Ahad three times, it is equal to reciting the whole Quran in its ajr. Also in another hadith, the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he says, whoever reads it 10 times, that Allah will build for him a house in Jannah. This is the surah of Tawheed. Suratul Ikhlas and Suratul Kafirun, it was from the sunnah of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to recite them together at Fajr. When we make the tawaf, rak'atain, to recite them then, in Salatul Duha, in the sunnah of Salatul Maghrib, and in the fajr of the traveler, the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he would recite these two surahs together because they purify, they renew our tawheed. This surah, Qul Huwa Allahu Ahad, it was revealed because a mushrik, he asked the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to describe Allah to him. What is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Describe Him to us. So Allah revealed this chapter. An ahad, it means He's one, not two. A samad, Ubay ibn Ka'ab radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he said, adding to the meaning that of Samad, it means He is self-sufficient. He is the Master who all creatures need. He doesn't eat nor He drinks. He added that of Samad, it is also the one who isn't born nor has children. Because what is born dies. Whatever is born, whichever, everything that's born that comes into existence, it dies. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala isn't like that. And whoever has children leaves inheritance. We don't think and understand that Isa alayhi salam will inherit the throne of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَعُوذُ بِاللَّهِ مِنْ ذَلِكَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when we look and understand Surah Al-Kafirun and Surah Al-Ikhlas, we understand why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, where He said, وَلَمْ يَقُلْ لَهُ كُفُوًا أَحَدٍ. This verse, that there is nothing similar unto Him, it shows us Allah is before everything. Nothing is before Him or with Him. And everything that exists in this universe is by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's qadr. Everything that happens is by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's qadr. And it's qada. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He said, laysa kamithlihi shay, that there isn't nothing similar unto Him. This chapter, Qul Hu Allahu Ahad, it refutes the Jews who say that Azir is the son of Allah. It refutes the Christians who say that Isa is the son of Allah. And the Majus who say that light and darkness are the two elements. It refutes the Mushrikeen who worships idols. Or the Mujassima, those people who liken Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Or it also refutes those who say incarnation, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala came down in the flesh of man. It refutes those who say Allah is everything and everything is Allah. These two chapters, my brothers and sisters, read them, make a habit to practice them in your life, and understand that through these two surahs is the most important aspect of our religion, which is the tawheed of worshiping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone, which is the tawheed of rububiyyah, making Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone in His dominion. He is the one who governs the affairs, and making Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala